So our broom stop consisted of lunch at Matzo's and fish and chips from Macca's Takeaway and a couple of nights at Broome Gateway Caravan Park, which for those who might be interested, is about 25 k's out of town, so it's well and truly the gateway, but just makes it a long round trip to nick into town. So we've fueled up and booted up, and we're grabbing the last of our supplies, which would be some of the new Matzo's hard lemon cans from the brewery itself. Just there. Had to wait till 11 o'clock before Lee could get served. So we're on the way to the Dampier Peninsula, and let's hope this is the real part of the adventure up there. Cheers. So the Juddigen campsite at the Juddigen Roadhouse, our home for the next 3 days. Reasonably new, great flat sites, good facilities, camp kitchen, laundry, and fire pit. Yeah, so good spot to base yourself, close to Lombardina and other attractions around the Dampier Peninsula. So take it all in. So today we're out at the Lombardina Aboriginal community and making our way down towards the beach. So after our drive through the sand dunes, not a long drive, you come to the Lombardina Beach, which you have to say is pretty spectacular.
They're just there. He's on. What is it?
So the Dampier Peninsula is famous for two of its churches, one at Lombardina and the other one at Beagle Bay. And this is the one at Lombardina. The church itself is built predominantly of mangrove wood with a paper bark roof. It was built in 1934 by the local community under the stewardship of the local missionary from Beagle Bay. So we've left our last camp and we're headed off towards Cygnet Bay, but taking the opportunity to go to Ardy Loon, One Arm Point, and check out what's going on up here. And yeah, pretty amazing little community. Here comes old Lemon Shark.
That's
So the situation with the Troker Shell hatchery is when you pay your permit fee to come in, you are given a tag that goes on your wrist, and that covers your entry fee into the hatchery and, well, what is basically now a marine display. So make sure you do it. This is your Troker hatchery. Also now has interpretive tanks of various parts of the coastline, like seagrass areas and reef areas and bits and pieces. So really good for kids. Outstanding, so they can come and have a look at the fish. And also the turtles, which are a big hit, like the clownfish. Signet Bay, we've arrived, and obviously varying levels of accommodation here from Flash Harry to where we're staying. But we're out with the real people, aren't we? So you get to Signet Bay and you pull up in the car park, if you can, and you come to the reception area to do your checking in. The restaurant's further along, so's the beach. This is the main beach at Signet Bay. It's also the area that they tell you you can launch your boat from. They will help you for a small fee, $50 to get it in, $50 to get it out. When we say out, the tide goes out. And what a difference a few hours makes. Here we are going out from Signet Bay. It's a little bit bumpier than we expected, but we'll poke around the bay itself, have a look. Plenty of structure. A bit of luck, we'll get a fish. Oh, the sharks have got it. The sharks have got it. Took the first decent fish and the shark cleaned it up. It was a bit of a battle going through there, but now I've got a shark on. Okay. Good fish too. It's a good GT, I think. Now I've just got to make sure I don't do anything stupid here, because I've got a bit of reef over here. Zip, 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 zip. I'll just keep her going. You can see him smashed it on the surface. Well, I might have to come back. Unfortunately ended as I expected. Cleaned up. Cleaned up. Okay. Anyway, we'll tie on another lure and we'll have another.
I've got bitten off first drop, so we'll try the jig and see how we go. New Bait and Tackle Direct Micro Jigs. See how we go with those.
How's that for a run? And bitten off again, don't tell me. catch something.
Oh, and I did. It was a massive mackerel just swam past. They just swam past a big mackerel.
A sunset.
And Oliver Martin. There you go, mate. The coral trout. Coral trout on the soft plastic. He's not size, but he is the right species. So I'm pretty bloody happy about it. And if you don't mind, just look at the colours. He is magnificent. That is a car in the water. So fucking far. To get that boat in. I don't know where you had to get in that far. There you go, get the registration number of that one and make sure you don't drive.
Apart from the obvious accommodation and dining options at Cygnet Bay, there's a range of sea tours. And
no need for a boat ramp because they use the old sea legs.
This little number here. So we're going on board this one today to do the Sunday Island cruise, which should be pretty interesting. Stick along.
In front of this today, because this is a traditional driftwood raft, it's called. In the Bali language, it's called a galwa. In the Jawi language, we call this the bilbil. And this is what our old people used to navigate in the early days before boats came along. And this is what they, the main transport. In the book, it's got in the photos, got some photos of old people going out to cut these. It's a kapok mangrove, so it only grows on certain parts of the coast. So our old people from Sunday Island, where they live, they use these. They use the tides and the currents to get to and from the islands. They use these for hunting and transporting around. So I'll talk more about them as we get to the islands. But I wanted to show you this first, because once we're out there and you see the currents and the tides, you can have an understanding of how our old people use these. We worked out paddleboarding a long time ago. We could have inherited those tricks to make us rich today, but not.
So that's it. Drive the boat in off the beach. And away we go.
I'm from Wanam Point community. I've lived here most of my life as well. So we have seven clan groups in this area. Five of them are on the mainland. Two is on the islands. So we've got Bunyol, Bunurai where we are. That's why I only do an introduction here, because it's not my traditional owner country to speak from. So I do an introduction at Bunyol. Ardeol is Wanam Point. Gujumin is Bulagun, and then we've got Olongon, which is Panda Bay as you're coming in. So the whole of the Dampier Peninsula make up the clan groups of the Badi and Jawi people. And then you've got the Jawi people, which is Sunday Island, and Inalabur, which is Jairi, which we'll probably go past today. I focus on my family's lived history, because Sunday Island is the home of my ancestors before it became a Sunday Island mission. So we came from a strong line of leaders. We have two chiefs of Sunday Island, which come from my grandfather's side. When I was 8 years old, my first time I lived in a house was when I was eight. First time I went to school was when I was eight. So for the history of Wanam Point community where I live, it's important for me to tell my story in that space. But then again, I tell my mother's story and a reflection of my grandparents, where they grew up. Traditional diets, yes. Boys still go out, they traditionally hunt. Gives it that taste as well. So our people didn't have to boil the water all the time. They went to water places where it was flowing and they could, you know, still drink it. This is sand, like I said, salt is it. And no crocodiles here.
Not this week.
No, but I have seen a track here. I won't lie. I have seen a track that come up when we come up. And but Wow, we, you know, we throw rock here when it's full tide. We just stand up back, then I'll throw rocks here.
So coming to the Sunday Island tour, you have the privilege of coming to Rosanna's secret swimming spot. I'll take you in and show you the fresh water and camp you up in here for a little while. So have a swim and just take it all in.
Sitting on the cliffs, you seen that all down the bottom? You had all the shields lined up, all the boomerangs and all the spears. So they were weapons as well. So they used the boomerangs, the shields, and the spears as weapons. So when they fought, they threw the spear. They got a bloke in the back of, you know, got him in the back of the back. What they got? What do you think that turned into?
Stingray.
Because of the long spear, the tail. Then the other one, they threw the boomerang, hit him on the back. Because you get them on the back, you hit them on the back, and then they hit them on the tail here. So you got the tail of the boomerang there, and on the back, the way it is, the way it's situated. And then when they smashed, another fellow in the front of the face, they smashed his face in with the shield. And that's how the hammerhead got that, because of our shields. And when you look at our traditional tools, our weapons, they are the turtle, the spear, the shield and the
bottom. So that's it, that's the end of the Sunday Island tour and Rosanna's cultural tour as well. So if you're at Cygnet Bay, make sure you come along and do this one. It's outstanding. Leaving Pender Bay, they're burning off as they do in the dry season, and we're on the second part of our Dampier Peninsula trip, heading to Pender Bay. Fingers crossed for good times there.